I'm 57, so I went to high school when David Bowie made the transition from Only for Rejects to mainstream. And what I mean by that is my friends, my closest friends, were a group of gay males, sexually precocious females, and musicians who were the rejects of this sort of high school group that we hung out with. And David Bowie was the linchpin musically of this group, who were more advanced musically than me. So they pulled me into his music. And then years later, I wrote a book in the Velvet Underground, one of the two most influential bands in the history of the world besides the Beatles, but by every poll, okay? And if it wasn't for David Bowie, no one would know those guys. So he was, just like he did for the Pixies when he upped them, and a band called The Neighborhoods, and a bunch of other bands. He did for the Velvet Underground, who, you know, Lou, he loved Lou. They were his heroes, and Iggy Pop. So we wouldn't even know those guys' names, really, right now. I'm convinced of it in mainstream rock history, were it not for David Bowie. So that's a big thing. And no least in that is that he gave people, he was the Lady Gaga of his time. He gave kids and people who felt out of place a place. So thank you, David, and you're up there. All them songs about stars and stuff. I wonder if he's up there. I looked up. Is he up there? Are you up there, Dave? If you are, I hope you're digging what's happening. Bowie fan. This song's dedicated to him because I miss him and I love him still.